look at this blessing. Like, look at this promise that God has just issued to my man Jacob. Like, this is huge, right? And the bigger the promise, the bigger the problem that follows. Now, I want you to see this because this is going to directly apply to your life. Like, what God has promised you, it may take a minute to come through, but I promise the one that spoke it is faithful, and he will see it through to the end. Even should you forget about it, your God will never forget about it. So I need you to remember, the promise God speaks, he'll bring to pass. Let me show you. I am with you, and will watch over you wherever you go, and I will bring you back to this land. I will not leave you until I have done what I have promised you. Ah, it's beautiful, baby. And Jacob sees a big God in this, right? But even though he sees a big God, because a lot of us can't see a big God when we hear about him, when we go to church, when we read scripture, when we see him at work in other people's life, but all of a sudden we internalize it, we bring it into our life, and we make him a baby God. You know what I'm saying? Like, even though he gives a beautiful promise to our life, for our family, for our livelihood, for where he is taking us, we seem to diminish it and don't accept it at face value for what it is. Like, it's a big promise that he gives us, but we're willing to settle for less. That's kind of what Jacob does here, because God just promised him descendants that will go to the east and the west, the north and the south, as many as stand on the seashore, right? He tells this great promise, and all of a sudden Jacob's like, oh my gosh, I've just met God, right? And he sets up that stone that he was laying on as a pillow as a pillar now. But this is what he says. If God will be with me and will watch over me on this journey I am taking and will give me food to eat and clothes to wear so that I return safely to my father's household, then the Lord will be my God. Hold up a minute. Jacob said, if I just have food to eat and clothes to wear, like, he'll be my God. And God's like, what are you talking about? Like, that is the least that I will do for you. I promise you, nations, baby, the west and the east, the north and the south, you will have descendants that spread throughout the entire earth to glorify my name. And you coming at me with clothes and food? Ah, raising expectations, Jacob. I got so much more for you. Jacob wasn't there yet. Like, I'm just telling you, Jacob's heart was not there yet. He's simply a heel grabber. He's the one that came on hanging on to Esau, right? Like, he is not there yet. He ain't willing to fight for the promise that God has for him. He is not that contender yet, but he will be. And God about to take him on a journey of journeys to get him to the point where he ain't going to settle for food and clothes no more. He's going to settle on the full promises of God, nothing less. And that's where I want to get you to today. Don't you dare settle for less when God has promised you the more. You don't just settle for food and clothes when God has promised you nations. You can't do it. Why? Because then you diminish the promise of your God. Your God is faithful. If he spoke big, he is going to deliver big. Don't you dare doubt it. Raise them eyes. Raise them standards. Raise them expectations. Your God is good at what he does. You ain't got to belittle it that he might come through for you. Your God can meet the expectations, the full expectations, all the expectations. So raise them standards.